हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 6, द चेंज अराउंड अस। इन आवर डेली लाइफ वी सी द सो मेनी चेंज लाइक राइपनिंग ऑफ फ्रूट्स, फ्लावरिंग ऑफ फ्रूट्स, चेंज इन वेदर और इन आवर होम लाइक कुकिंग ऑफ फूड। सो दीज आर ऑल चेंज। हाउ कैन वी डिटेक्ट दैट सम सब्सटेंस गेट्स चेंज्ड व्हेन when substance undergoes change when substance undergoes change then maybe its shape its size its state its color and internal and its internal structure may be changed whenever substance undergoes any kind of change then substance shape size state color internal structure maybe gets changed internal structure what does mean by internal structure means the substance internal structure maybe in your previous chapter you may have studied about the internal structure like this is bench and any substance or anything is made up by the atoms so these are atoms and when atoms are arranged in a specific pattern then substance or things are made when substance undergoes change then maybe its arrangement of atoms maybe gets changed so this is internal structure now the second this is change that whenever change the substance substance gets change in terms of its shape size color state internal position and here now I am going to classify the change as classification of change classification of change as human made change human made change means that change occurs because of human activities and natural change the change that occurs because of natural activities the example of human made change is such as cooking of food because cooking of food is a type of change in which that is occurred because of the human activities cooking of food and one important thing is that every change has cause like what is the cause of burning of cooking of food because we heat the food which is as a raw material and then this food is allowed to be heated then foods undergoes change so who heat the food that is not cooked before that so the food is cooked by us so the reason of the cooking of food is because of the human activities so this change is classified as under the human made change natural change such as changing in weather weather condition weatheric condition like rain, like moisture, that weatheric conditions change are under control of nature. So this class, this classification of change is are classified as natural change. I hope you have understood till here. Now we I am going to tell you about the change, classification of change as reversible change or irreversible change. We can classify the change as reversible or irreversible change also besides the classification of change as human made change and natural change. So now let's start the classification of the change as a new terms. So classification of change as first reversible and the second other is irreversible. The meaning of reversible is that we can that substance can be reversed. The simple meaning of reversible is that substance or things can be reversed into its original position. So the meaning of reversible is that substance or things can be reversed, can becomes back into its original position, and can come back into its original position. That's the meaning of the reversible. And if I write the irreversible change, means if substance or things can be come back into its original position after being changed. So that type of change is reversible change. The example of this change is, this is a general example that we see generally in our home, such as this is a ice tray. And if we put water in this ice tray and allow its tray to put under the refrigerators, then if we put this ice tray into the refrigerator, then after some time this water is in the condition of liquid condition. Here water which is present in this tray in liquid condition, and after putting in the refrigerator, after some times this water which is previously in the state of liquid state, then after some time or after few hours, this tray's water gets changed into ice cubes. So this is ice cubes, and this is the water. And here in the ice cube, water is present in the state of solid state. Here water is present in liquid state, and here is water is present in solid state. Means that water gets changed from liquid to solid. And when we so this change is reversible because ice can be converted into water again. Ice cubes again can be converted into water, which is as a liquid state. So this change is reversible change. And now comes at the change of irreversible. Irreversible just opposes of the reversible change. Can you assume that what happened during the irreversible change? The meaning irreversible mean is the substance that cannot be come back into its original position after being changed. Just opposite of this definition. Irreversible change. The meaning of irreversible is that substance during the irreversible change, substance cannot be come back into its original condition or into its original position. Into its original position after being changed. The example of reversible change is the formation of curd. Curd formation is occurred from the milk. This is the warm milk, and when we add some curd, then after some time or after few hours, what happen? After few hours, this milk gets changed into curd. So this is curd. Can this curd be changed into its original position as milk? No, it cannot be changed into its original position. So this change is a type of irreversible change. The other example of irreversible change is like burning of paper. Why burning of paper comes under the irreversible change? Burning of paper, because after being burned, paper converts into ash, and smoke, carbon dioxide and water vapors emerged, and ash cannot be converted. Ash means the substance that is left behind after burning the paper. That substance we call ash, such as this paper, and after burning there is black substances left behind, so that is ash. So this ash, black color substance we call ash, and this ash cannot be converted again into paper. So this type of change is also under come as irreversible change. So I hope you have understood this. Now we come again the classification of chains as in another terms. Till now we have studied the chains, the classification of chains as in terms of human change or natural change, or in terms of reversible change or irreversible change. Now the last classification of change as the physical change or chemical change. Classification of change as physical change or chemical change. When substance undergoes any change. Then if after being undergone the change, if new substance are formed, then that change is considered as physical change. When new substance are formed, then we call that type of change is undergone as physical change. The example of physical change is such as water which is in liquid condition, the changing of water in ice which is solid state. That change we call physical change. No aega. Here no comes before new. No new substance are formed in the physical change. Any new substance are not formed. So water converts into ice. So here physical properties, only physical properties change. Physical property gets changed. In physical properties, what type of properties comes under physical properties? Like shape, size and state. These properties are undergone as physical change. So only physical properties, such as this state's properties are as physical properties. So here only physical property change. Liquid, here water converts into its liquid state to solid state. So here physical property gets changed. No new substance are formed. So this type of change as comes under the physical change. The next other things is that mostly physical change are the type of reversible change. Means after being changed, the substance can be converted into its original position. Can ice be converted into its original position? Yes. Ice, when we allow ice to put openly for some time, then ice can be converted into water. So this is reversible change also. So mostly physical changes are reversible change. Now our last change is chemical change. In chemical change, just opposite of physical change. Here no new substance are formed and here new substance are formed. New substance are formed and mostly chemical changes are irreversible changes. Mostly chemical changes as irreversible change. Irreversible change means the substance that cannot be converted or cannot be come back into its original original condition or original position after being changed. So that type of change is chemical change. The example of chemical change is, we can again take the example when took under the irreversible change. So the example of chemical change is the formation of curd. The formation of curd is a change or as a chemical change. Formation of curd. When milk gets converted into curd after putting some curd then this changes chemical change, because here new substance, what type of new substance are here formed? Curd. And most, and this is irreversible change also, because this cannot, curd always cannot be converted into milk. So this is chemical change. Next other property of next other example of chemical change is like burning of paper. Burning of paper, not tearing of paper. Tearing of paper is physical change, but burning of paper is chemical change. Because when we tear paper, then no new substance are formed, only its shape gets changed. So this tearing of paper comes under the physical change. Burning of paper comes under the chemical change, because new substance, ash, smoke are generated. So, and burning of paper, after being burned, paper cannot be comes back into its original position. So burning of paper comes under the chemical change. So let's sum up what we have discussed today. We discussed what is change, the change that we occur and around us in terms of the change in shape, size, structure, state, or here so many terms in which we can see the change that occurs around us. So and every change has cause. Change can be classified as human change or natural change. Change can be classified as physical change or chemical change. Change can be classified as reversible or irreversible change. So I hope you have enjoyed this video and gets understood very well. Thank you. Have a nice day.